Hey guys, this is Language Engineer and you made it already to the third video. So in this video we will discuss the introduction of the lesson 3 series. And as you can see, we have 6 videos for the lesson 3 series. And let's go through what we will discuss in each video. So this video right now is video 1. So what we will discuss in this video is mainly the vocabulary which you need for lesson 3. And then in the second video, we will discuss some affirmative questions. So how do you create yes and no questions? And then to learn that more and practice that, we have some homework. So make sure that you do the homework and write the homework down in the comments below the video. And I will check and correct each homework. So I will give each student a mark for the homework so that you have some feedback and you will know where are your weaknesses, okay? Then in video 3 we will review German pronouns. We already discussed them before, and we will also learn how to create questions with the question word who. So who means wer in German. And also here we have a homework. Make sure that you do the homework and write down the homework in the comment section, and I will check the homework for everyone. And then in video 4, we will have a listening practice. So here you can listen to my reading and you can try to hear the missing words in the text. And this is what Yusuf is doing. Yusuf is my student, and he will try to hear what is missing. You can do that at the same time too. Then in video 5, we will learn the question words wo, wohin, woher. And we will also discuss the homework. I will not tell you the solution for the homework, but I give you some guidance. And then you will know how to use it by yourself, and you will also know how to use aus, in, nach. I will explain the words in just a second. So in video 6, I will discuss the homework for the previous videos from lesson 3, and I will maybe also show some of the good students. Maybe you are one of the students who did the homework right, and maybe I will show a screenshot and discuss the homework from you. So let's start with the pronouns. The first one is ich. We have learned this means I. So now when we go through the vocabulary, I will go through quickly, and if you have any problem, you can just stop the video at any time. But actually, most of the vocabulary are vocabulary which we already studied, so I will go through quickly, and this is just important that you know all the vocabulary so that you have no problem to understand lesson 3. So the next one is du. Du means the informal you, and we have two you's, right? So this first one here, du, is the singular you, informal, and then we have ihr, which is the plural you, also informal. Then we have er, sie, es means he, she, it. Then we have wir, means we. Sie is the formal you, and you can see that I use the capital letter S, because when we use the formal U, we always use the capital letter. And then we have Z again, but here it means they. And for example, if there are some people here and we are talking about them, then we can use Z. And the next thing I want to discuss are verbs which we use in lesson 3. So the first verb is kommen, and this means to come. Then we use fahren, and this means to drive. And one information for you, if you also want to practice your pronunciation, you can stop the video after I read a new vocabulary, and you can try to repeat the word. Okay, I continue. Then we have lesen. Lesen means to read. And arbeiten means to work. Wohnen means to live. I live in a place. For example, I live in Germany, I live in America, or something like that. Then we have reisen. Reisen means to travel. Then we have heißen. We have already learned that before. This is to be called. Then we have sein, which is to be. And here you need to be aware that the conjugations of sein is a bit complicated because it's an irregular verb. And we will discuss this more in detail in another video. Then liegen means to lie, such as to be located. For example, Deutschland liegt in Europa, Germany lies in Europe. So actually it means here to be located. The next section is the question words. Wer means who, and wo means where. A lot of German students who study English, they have a problem with who and where. And now you can see why, because wo means where, and wer means who. So it's a bit confusing, right? Because it looks like opposite of the of English. Okay, woher means where from. For example, where are you from? Woher kommst du? Then the next one is where to. So for example, you are going to a place, you're going to Germany, then you can say, wohin gehst du? So that's why I made here a question mark, because you're going somewhere. And if you want to ask the question for that, then you use wohin. Okay, the next one is wie, and the translation is how. And we use wie, for example, for the question, wie heißt du? What's your name? Then we have some nouns, which we also use in lesson 3. Das Buch means the book. Der Urlaub means the holiday. Der Zug means the train. And der Tee means the tea. And what you need to pay attention to is the article. You need to remember all the genders here. Because, you know, in the German language we have three. We have der, die, das. And each noun has a different gender, so you need to memorize and study all of them. But don't be afraid, you will get used to it. So now maybe you will think, well, I need to learn all the genders for each noun. Now, in the beginning, maybe you think it's challenging, but after some time you will get used to it and it's normal. And then we have also some other words, for example, sehr, this means very. Then we have viel. Viel means a lot or much. Aus means from. In means in. Nach means to. Mitten in means in the middle of. Right? Mitten in. Okay? And then we also use a lot of cities in lesson 3. And also countries. So what you can do now, you can repeat each city after me. Okay? Dortmund. Dortmund. Dortmund is here. Then München. München. Aachen. Aachen. Aachen is now not in the list, but it's also in North Rhine-Westphalia. Then Düsseldorf. Düsseldorf is here. Düsseldorf. Essen. Essen. Berlin. Berlin. Hamburg. Hamburg. Wien. Wien. And you can see Wien has a different color because this is a city which is not from Germany. This is the capital city of Austria. Austria is here. And the next one, Köln. Köln. Köln is here. Okay, next one, Frankfurt. Frankfurt. Frankfurt is here. And you can also say in German, Frankfurt ist hier. Frankfurt ist hier. Okay, then Peking. Peking is Beijing. It's the capital city of China. Paris. Paris. And Paris is the capital city of France. Okay, and then we have some countries, which we also use in lesson 3. These are, for example, Deutschland. You should know what it is. This is Germany. Russland is Russia. Österreich is Austria. Is here. Then we have Spanien. Spanien. And this is Spain. What I want to tell you is that you should watch all the videos and especially do all the homeworks, because I give you the chance that I correct all your homeworks, and this is the perfect chance for you to get some feedback. And I would promise you, if you do the homework, you will improve your German quite fast. And if you haven't subscribed until now, then do it now so that you don't miss any video, and see you in the next video. And don't forget to like this video if you like, and if not, then dislike. See you!